Thank you, everyone. You perhaps have been seeing these stories on your television screen, on your Twitter handles, and perhaps every social media platforms that you engage on. You see these stories of the factions. But how does this affect you as a person? Well, let me break it down for you. The people that are affecting are either your governors or your lawmakers, or it involves those who lead you. So their activities invariably affect the policies and the activities of governance. So I have on the panel tonight on the program, breaking it down from both sides that are involved majorly in all of these defection issues. The spokesperson of the PDP, the main opposition party, Mr. Kola Ologbondiyan, and the former Senate leader, a member of the APC, Senator Ali Ndume. Thank you so much for being part of the program tonight. Mr. Ologbondiyan, quickly, if you can tackle the question I asked earlier, you were on that point before we went on break, because of some of the things, the reasons why people are running to your party, which the chairman of the APC alleged that there are no free monies and they're not sharing monies again, and that's why they are fleeing the APC.
Well, Sheung, before I go into that, you earlier said something about the Minister of Information, Alhaji Lai Mohammed, contending issues with Senator Bukola Saraki in Kwara. I know for sure, because I've also been a political reporter like you, that Alhaji Lai Mohammed knows it in his heart of hearts that he's not a match for Senator Bukola Saraki in Kwara. And I want to leave it at that. But going into the issue of the factional chairman of APC, Adams Oshiomhole, claiming that there's no money to share, that's why people are leaving their party, I think it's a misplaced analysis. And I also want to let you know and let Nigerians know that Comrade Adams Oshiomhole has talked the All Progressives Congress into troubled waters. And as such, in a normal democratic setting, the president, President Muhammadu Buhari, ought to have called him in and cautioned him. Because he's no longer doing the job of a conciliator that is expected to do in the party. In the People's Democratic Party, we don't take him serious. We don't mind what he's saying. We see him as somebody who does not understand the difference between labor unionism and real politics. So all that he's doing, as far as the People's Democratic Party is concerned, is that he's just belaboring himself over issues that are of no importance in the political arena. Here you are as a national chairman, as a factional chairman of a party. You are losing members. You have lost three governors. You have lost 37 members of the House of Representatives. You have lost 15 plus senators, or at least 16 senators. And you say you don't lose sleep. It is clear to every Nigerian that you have not been sleeping. And if you claim not to lose sleep, then it means that you are not concerned about your party. We are very concerned about the People's Democratic Party. We are interested in making it a party that is acceptable to the majority of Nigerians.
All right.
And that is why today we are receiving governors, we are receiving deputy governors, we are receiving National Assembly members in the Senate and in the House of Representatives. We are receiving State Assemblies members. And we are also receiving
Mr. Ologbondiyan, let me quickly allow, and let me give Mr. Ologbondiyan the opportunity to perhaps be the last speaker on the panel tonight. Mr. Ologbondiyan, as we approach 2019, with all of these defections, you heard Senator Ali Ndume, who did say, look, this will not affect the fortune of the party going forward into that election. Just in about 30 or 40 seconds that we have left, do you think that your party can actually give a fight to a Buhari candidacy in 2019?
I know. Let me go into the issue of the Senate. I know, because I've had the privilege of working in that environment, that the Senate president reserves the right to reconvene the Senate. And I will rely on Section 12 of the Senate Standing Rule, which reads, whenever the Senate stands adjourned either to a date fixed or the rule of the Senate or to a date determined in accordance with paragraph 1 of the rule, and it is represented by the leaders of the political parties in the Senate, to the president of the Senate, that the public interest required that the Senate should meet on an earlier or a later date or time than that on which it stands adjourned,
okay.
The president of the Senate may give notice accordingly, and the Senate shall meet on the date and at the time stated in the notice. It is the responsibility of the Senate president to determine when the Senate will reconvene. That is one. Two, distinguished Senator Aliyu Dume was on the floor the day
we need to close the program because we're out of time.
And as such, it is wrong and amount to a blackmail to say that he shut down the Senate. Senator Bukola Saraki did not shut down the Senate.
Okay,
however, okay, on, the issue,
we need to close the program.
I want to assure you
my hands are tied because time is no longer on our side. But it's very unfortunate that we don't have time. But I wish that we have opportunity to speak more about it. We will surely find time, especially with you and Senator Aline Dume. Maybe on a Sunday that we will have more time on the program. Senator Aline Dume, many thanks for coming on the program. Mr. Kola Ologbodunyan, thank you also for being on the show tonight. Well, that's our program for tonight. Thank you so much for being part of the show. I'm Shimon Kimale. Bye-bye.